A couple of things you're gonna need to do this job. Tire iron or a wrench. You will need a C-clamp, probably at least 9 inches long. You'll obviously need your new rotor, your new brake pads, brake pad lubrication, hammer. A rubber mallet will work better, but if you're cheap like me and don't want to run to the store for the third time today, you can just throw some cloth on a hammer and tape it on there. And then you'll need a light and probably another light. And then this is optional, but I like to use anti-seize on pretty much every bolt I put on my car, whether it's on the lug nut or in the bolts holding on the caliper. You may need a crowbar to get the old brake rotor off. I know I did. That's why you see all that rust down there. Thing did not want to come off. All right, the first thing that you're going to want to do is lift the car. You can see I have two pallet jacks under there just in case it falls. Next, take tire iron or whatever you've got, take off the plastic lug nut caps, and then lug nuts themselves. All this is loose already because I've already taken it off. I just decided to do the video, so I put everything back on, but very loosely. The parts of the car, this is the brake rotor, this is the caliper, which houses your brake pads. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to do is remove the brake caliper. So you come in here, and you take off this bolt, which is the upper bolt. You're going to want to take off the upper bolt, which is right here, and you're also going to want to take off the lower bolt right here. It's just two bolts that hold on the caliper. Don't have a torque wrench, I use a hammer. Once you've removed the bolts, you should be able to easily remove your brake caliper. Like I said, this houses your old brakes, which just slide into place. This is where you'll use your coat hanger or string. Put it through the bolt hole. I like to just hang it from the coil spring in the suspension. And that way, you're not putting strain on your brake line. Okay, it's the brake caliper hanging from the coat hanger on the coil spring. And there's the brake line in the back. You can see it right here. If you let it hang by that, it most likely won't hurt anything, but the way I see it, why risk it, right? And then, like I said, the first time I took this rotor off, it was very hard, but you just remove it, and then you have your hub and your studs. Okay, now we're going to remove the brake pads. This is the outer pad. This is the stationary pad. The inner pad is the one that moves forward to stop the vehicle. You'll notice on the outer pad it has this hook. The hook is what makes the whining noise when your brake pad gets too low. This one's actually got a little bit of pad left on it, but it's kind of corroded. And well, I changed the other side, so I'm going to change this side. Remove that. Reach in. Remove the inner pad. That right there is your caliper piston. This is the part when you need to use your C-clamp. I'm using the old brake pad, the inner pad on the piston. Set up the C-clamp and you simply tighten it as much as you can to push the piston back in. Next step is you want to take your new brake pad, take your lubricant, and lubricate the back plate. When you're doing this, you also want to make sure you get the outer clips. And now I know that this is the outer brake pad because it has the clip on it, which makes the noise to warn you when your pad is too low. So I simply place that in the caliper, make sure the clips line up, and push it into place. Then I do the exact same thing with the other brake pad. Take the brake pad, place it in the caliper, try not to drop it. And there you go. The next step is to take your brand new rotor. This happens to be a machined rotor, not a brand new one. Simply place it on the hub. There are mosquitoes everywhere. At this point, I loosen my coat hanger so I can get the caliper unhooked. And I make sure to take out the coat hanger now, just so I don't leave it in there, as I have a tendency to do. And if you push the piston in all the way, the caliper should fit over the rotor relatively easily. Now this is the part where you may need your hammer. Okay. Once you have the caliper on, you have to make sure to line it up with the holes for the bolts you took out in the first place. This can be a little bit of a pain in the butt, but it's really not that difficult. You want to tighten the top bolt first, then the bottom bolt. So you want to tighten them back in the reverse order that you removed them. Okay, and that's all there is to it. Then the last step to set your brakes. Start your car. And pump the brake pedal all the way down to the floor several times. And that's it. Last step, take her for a test drive. And whenever you're done changing your brakes, after you go and take it on your test drive, it's always a good idea to come and check the brake fluid. And see, mine's full. This is the 3A engine. I'm not exactly sure where the brake fluid is on the 3-4, but I'm sure you can find a diagram somewhere online or in your owner's manual. And just as a little side note, the power steering fluid on the GM 3.8 liter V6, it's down, behind here. Like, you have to reach your arm down. Okay, you have to reach your arm down there to get to it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. But if you want to check your power steering fluid, that's where that is.